my song. Let's sing it. It's gonna be fucking awesome. Come on. It's gonna be fucking awesome. You know the words. It's gonna be fucking awesome. That's it. Sing. It's gonna be fucking awesome.
Hey ho, Jesse Blaze Snyder here, and welcome to Saturday edition of Coolest Geek Alive, where we like to bring your attention to fucking awesome media, TV shows, movies, whatever, that deserve your time and attention. And today, I want to bring you to a movie that, you know, I didn't hear anything about it. I don't really know anything about, like, the behind the scenes of it. It just showed up, was apparently made in 2017, showed up on TV. I don't even know why. I think I watched it on Netflix, whatever. It's on Netflix right now. I rewatched it just last night, and I loved it so much. It's not a typical movie that I would call like a what do you call it? I wouldn't call it like a geek culture movie per se, or that it naturally appeals to the geek culture audience. But at the end of the day, I don't care about that really. I mean, like, that's the whole thing. Like, I just like things that are great, and it's great. Really, really cool. Stars Vince Vaughn in, you know, fairly different kind of role for him. The whole movie is very understated. It's not rated, apparently, and I guess was released without an MPA rating. It's like 2 hours and 12 minutes, and it's a little bit of a slow burn. So, like, if you're looking for something that's, like, really fast-paced and whatnot, this isn't it. But boy, it makes you feel something. His life situation from the very beginning is very kind of simple and compelling and difficult. And the relationship with his girl is simple and compelling and kind of difficult in the beginning. And, you know, goes somewhere really positive where you want to see some sort of happy ending, you know, come for this guy, even though, you know, you're only barely going to get, you know, anything close to a happy ending in this movie. So don't expect that. But it's really, really a great flick. I'll read you the little simple thing. It says, a former boxer turned drug runner lands in a prison battleground after a deal gets deadly. And basically the story of the movie is that he's like a down on his luck guy who has to turn to crime for, you know, taking care of his family, and ultimately ends up in jail and embroiled in some terrible things because he's kind of an honorable guy, and he screws himself. It's very compelling. It's very compelling. It's very cool. You know, it's a great role for Vince Vaughn, who's the lead. Jennifer Carpenter plays Lauren Thomas, his wife. Jennifer Carpenter, if you're a Dexter fan, is Dexter's sister. And then Don Johnson plays the warden at, like, the highest security prison in the movie. He's great in it. Also, Udo Kier, he's a character actor. You might know that guy's name. He plays a cool guy from the shady underworld kind of thing. Mark Blucas has a small role in it that's solid. I mean, really, there's just, like, lots of, like, smaller roles, but they're all very solid and cool. You'll recognize plenty of the character actors, and, you know, there's plenty of really awesome, brutal fights in the movie. Really, like, super, super cool on that front. And it is, like, slow pace, so it'll be, like, you know, slow pace, and then all of a sudden it'll be bop, 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 you know, things will get really crazy. But it's super cool. What do I want to tell you about it besides the thing? Well, real quick anyway, I should say, thank you so much for listening to our show. If you don't know, I do a Monday night podcast for music. I just did DMX last week. It's a feature of all these different bands. There's like 30 episodes. You can check it out. And I also started a esoteric wisdom show every Friday. It's a show called Everything They Don't Want You to Know. What's it about? It's about everything they don't want you to know. All the powerful people around the world, the things that they would prefer you not to know so that you can stay Disempowered. And then every Saturday I do a version of this show, or Sunday night, sorry, called Coolest Geeks Alive Stream with my best buddy Aaron Sparrow. And we do, I've been interviewing him right now on his career as an editor and stuff. Been super cool. And then lastly, Fucking for Our Future is this awesome comic book that I have out right now. And it is really, really rad, and you would really dig it. It's very funny. It's very innocent and not like gross like a lot of people have been imagining sometimes. Very, very funny and lighthearted and cool. I highly recommend you check it out. It's live now on Kickstarter. Fucking for Our Future. Okay. Anyway, back to the movie. The thing that I really want to like say about this movie, even though plenty of the elements are elements that I've seen in other movies before, there is just something very unique about this movie. I have such a hard time comparing it to any other movies. It's very unique. It has like a sick sense of humor, but not much humor to it. It's pretty somber, and that's not typically the type of movie that like I like to see. It's kind of like crazy in its darkness and like the terrible pit that this kind of reasonable guy gets lost in. And I mean, really, like, you know, we were talking about heroes on previous episode of the show, where the last episode was all about like racism and shit. And we were talking about, you know, just like making the heroic characters, you know, really have to fight for it. And that often, like, they don't make the women, especially. And also their diverse cast. Sometimes they don't want to like put them through as much things. They don't want to abuse them because they feel that they're already an abused class. So they abuse them less. Well, it gives all the advantage to the white male characters who the writers and the directors and the producers are willing to abuse more, because ultimately abuse subjected on your character is kind of sickly what your audience generally really wants for the characters. You know, they need to see them go through things and grow. And this is an interesting one, like in terms of what level of growth is this man having and so many things. And, you know, you're imagining what he went through before this and the different things that they had went through before this as a couple, because a lot of it, you know, so much of the movie is ultimately based on his relationship and trying to get things right with this person. And I really related to that on a lot of different levels, and, you know, him taking it seriously and meaning something to him, you know, in a really strong way. I didn't watch a trailer for this movie or anything. I just was like, I needed a movie to watch one night, and I just put it on. And I really think that that's actually kind of behooves you to do that. And I'm like trying not to spoil anything. I mean, I try not to spoil the movies in general and just kind of talk about them conceptually. But I really think this is a cool ass drama movie, drama action flick with a lot of heart. You know, that I guess like takes place in the crime world, but it's not so much about the crime as it's like this guy's human journey. And it's heavy and real and brutal. It's brutal. It's a really brutal film. And but it is great. There's brutal films that I don't like as much because it's just too brutal and it's just too heavy-handed and too just beat me up. I just feel like I went through a harrowing experience, but I don't feel like I gained anything from it. I think you'll definitely feel like you gained something from the experience of watching this movie. Vince Vaughn's performance is very understated, and the script is very understated, but what happens in the movie and just how it all lays out, it's really great. I don't want to call it like a masterpiece or anything, but it's unique and awesome and cool, and I have not heard enough people talk about how great it is. So reminder to all of you guys that it's great and you should fucking go seek it out. I'm going to close this show on my song, on my band Dilf USA. We've got this a great cover song. It's a mashup of Two Live Crew and AC/DC. Two Live Crew has a song called We Want Some Pussy, and AC/DC has a song called TNT. So it's the music of TNT to the lyrics and melody of We Want Some Pussy by my band Dilf USA. And yesterday, a video was put out that me and my girl produced and directed. It's like great. She worked on it. Her brother, she co-directed with her brother. And It's so great. You know, it really is so funny. Julie wrote the script of this thing. It's very, very, very just hilarious. And I can't wait for people to watch it. You know, by the time you hear this, I'm recording before Friday. So I haven't, it hasn't like come out yet. So I haven't seen like any reaction or anything, but it's very genuinely funny. Just like that comic I was telling you about. It's really funny. And I hope you guys will dig it. We're going to close this episode with the song so you can hear it. And I really hope you like it. Anyway, thank you for joining me for our Saturday Coolest Pick. I hope maybe you'll join me again Sunday night with me and Aaron Sparrow while we do the Coolest Geeks Alive stream. Usually we do that around 7 o'clock Pacific time. And then, of course, join me again on Wednesday where we'll be talking about the state of geek culture for another fucking awesome episode of the Coolest Geek Alive. Love you guys. Care Bear Stare. Peace.
We interrupt your regularly scheduled program to bring you this public service announcement.
Hey, yay!
Oi! Oi! Oi!
Hey,
oi,
yay!
Oi! Oi! Oi!
Hey,
oi,
yay!
Oi! Oi! Oi!
Hey,
oi,
yay!
Oi! Oi!
You see, me and my homies like to play this game. We call it Amtrak, but some call it the train. We all would line up in a single file line and take our turns at waxing girls behinds. But every time it came to me, I was shit out of luck. I'd stick my dick in and it would get stuck. The girl would say stop, I'd say I'm not. That's enough, I quit cause you're all busting me out. I said girls don't hide it, just
been listening to Coolest Geek Alive with me, your host, Jesse Blaze Snyder. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe for more
excellent geek culture content. Thanks for listening.